subscribe my channel for G and NEET.
Hello students, good morning all of you. In our yesterday class we were learning the parallel shift of the vectors and the angle between any two vectors. So here in this session we want to learn the addition of the two vectors. So how we can add two vectors with the graphical method and also the algebraic method. So here, so in our previous session, so there was two points to remember. So that was first point, it is if A comma B or B are having angle theta, then A and KB also have an angle theta. So here this is the vector A and vector B having an angle theta, and you should write A and KB also having an angle theta, same angle. So here this is A and KB, K times of B, K times of B, that's why the length will be increases. So here the angle it is same. So here K is the positive constant. K is positive constant. Similarly, if A comma B are having angle theta, then A and minus KB have angle, it is 180 minus theta. Already we wrote that. Here A and this is B, angle theta. This is A and this is B. This is minus KB. So here the angle between A and minus KB, it is 180 degrees minus theta, 180 minus theta. So these are very important to addition of the two vectors. So coming to the today's topic, how we can add two vectors in the graphical methods. Addition of the vector, addition of the vectors, addition of the vectors. So this is nothing but called as graphical method, graphical method. First point. So if two vectors are having same direction, if two vectors are having same direction, then how we can add both are? If P comma Q are the vectors having in same direction, then the addition of vector, so this is vector P and this is vector Q. How we can add both the vectors? So these two vectors are having the same direction. So here the initial point of the second vector should be added to the final point of the first vector. So this is the first vector, that is P. This is the initial point of the second vector, so that is Q, will be added to each other. Then the resultant vector will be, so this is the resultant vector what we have to add it. So that is P plus Q, R is equal P plus Q. So this is the addition of the vector where the two vectors having maintained same direction. So coming to the second case, if two vectors are having with some angle, two vectors having with some angle. So here this is the vector A and vector B having some angle theta. So then we can add these two vectors by the parallel shift of the vectors. So here A and this is B and this is the, because of the initial point of the second vector is added to the final point of the first vector. So then this shift, it is known as the parallel shift, and here R is equal A plus B. So this is the addition of vector when two vectors are maintaining with some angle between them. If two vectors are maintaining the same direction, then we can add it by the first method. Right, now what are the laws obeys the addition of vectors? So addition of vectors, addition of vectors obeys commutative law. So what is commutative law? So whereas P plus Q, it is equal Q plus P. This is a vector P and Q. By the parallel shift we can write, so this is Q, where it is R, it is equal P plus Q, and by the parallel shift of the vector P, so this is the P, and by this adding Q plus P, R it is equal Q plus P, therefore R is equal Q plus P and it is equal P plus Q. So this is the addition of the vector, this is the resultant vector. So the addition of vector obeys commutative law. And the second one, the addition of vector obeys associative law. The addition of vector obeys associative law, that is P plus Q plus R is equal P plus Q plus R. So how can we write that? So this is vector P and this is vector Q, this is vector R, it is equal P plus Q, and this is the vector R, this is the vector R, and we can add both of P plus Q and R. So here there is a vector, the resultant vector, here it is P plus Q plus R. And coming to the P plus Q plus R, P plus Q plus R, so this is the vector Q and this is the vector R, where this is the Q plus R. So then this is the vector P, we can add these two, that is nothing but P plus Q plus R, P plus Q plus R, so this is equal P plus Q plus R. So this is the addition of vector. The addition of vector obeys associative law. So this is the associative law. And the third one, it is the addition of vector obeys distributive law. So what is the distributive law? So here the vector P into addition of vector obeys distributive law. Can be P into K1 plus K2, it is equal P K1 plus P K2. So this is the addition of the vector. Or K into P plus Q, it is equal KP plus KQ. K is the, here K is the constant. So this is the distributive law. Addition of vector will obey the distributive law. So here one application is there. So that was, if a man moving towards moving towards north or sorry east with displacement 3 meter and moving north with the displacement 4 meter. So then what is the angle between these two sides or these two directions? So how we can find that? So here, so this is the direction of the earth, north, south, east, west. So here this is the origin point. If a man moving towards east with 3 meter, so this is the x direction and this is the y direction, minus x minus y, and from this position he can, and moving with north displacement of 4 meter, so this is the displacement of the man with 4 meter. So here the angle between these two, so here this is also 3 meter, so this is the angle between these two, this can be R. So from this we can write that the horizontal displacement of the man with the x axis, that is 3 meter with the x axis, so this is x east, so vector form it is in the x direction, that is I factor, I unit vector 3i, and in the y direction this is also 4 meter, so these are will be same 3i plus in the y direction, that is 4j, so this is the resultant vector r, it is equal 3i plus 4j. So we can write that r it is equal under root of the magnitude of these vectors 3 square plus 4 square. We can write it is 9 plus 16, it is 25, it is 5 meter. So here this is the 5 meter. So now we have to find that the angle between here OAB. From the triangle we can write that R it is equal to 5 meters. So we can find whatever the angle it is, just we have to find sine theta. What is the sine theta? Here we can write it is opposite by hypotenuse, that is 4 by 5. And from cos theta we can write adjacent by hypotenuse 3 by 5. And tan theta it is equal, whereas 4 by 5 into 5 by 3. So it is 4 by 3. Tan theta it is equal 4 by 3. Theta it is equal tan inverse of 4 by 3. So the angle between these two directions, that is theta is equal tan inverse of 4 by 3. So here we need to find the vector formation of sine theta and cos theta, whereas tan theta. So directly we can find tan theta, whereas opposite by adjacent, it is 4 by 3. It is 4 by 3. So this is the method we have to find the angle between any two directions. So please take screenshot and note down points. And next, the subtraction of the vectors. The subtraction of the vectors is also nothing but a subtraction. Subtraction of the vectors. It is also one of the addition of the vector. If vector A and vector minus B will be added to each other, then A minus B will become. It is the vector A and it is the minus vector minus B. So they can be added to each other, A plus of minus B. So then we can write that A minus B. So this is the vector A minus B. So The subtraction of the vector is also nothing but a addition of the vector in the vertical components. Right. First, suppose this is the vector P and this is the vector Q. So we can find the vector, this is the minus Q. So we can add both are, so then we can shift the vector. So this is the parallel shift, this can be vector Q. So then both are will be added, R it is equal P plus P minus P plus Q. So this is the Q vector, this is the minus Q vector. So in this way, if two vectors will be added to each other, one positive vector and negative vector will be added to each other, so then we can get the subtraction of the vector. The subtraction is nothing but the addition of the vector with the parallel shift. So here the subtraction of the vectors also of the vectors, it cannot obey the, it cannot obey the commutative law. It cannot obey the commutative law. So here P minus Q is not equal to the Q minus P. So coming to the magnitude of the P minus Q, it is equal magnitude of the Q minus P. But it is not equal to the P minus Q is not equal to Q minus P. But coming to the magnitudes, minus P minus Q, modulus of P minus Q is equal to modulus of Q minus P. And coming to the second point, it does not obey associative law. So it does not obey associative law. So that is nothing but P minus Q minus R, it is equal P minus Q minus R. So it does not obey. Whereas third one, coming to the third one, the vector subtraction can obey distributive law. So that is nothing but K into P minus Q, it is equal KP and minus KQ. K it is the positive constant here. So these are the laws behind the addition of the vectors and subtraction of the vectors. And now, if the vectors can position at different quadrants, how we can write that? So quadrant of the vectors, this is the x-axis and this is the minus x-axis, this is the y-axis and the negative y-direction, and there is the vector, it can be vector A, it is B, it is C and it is D. So then we can write that the vector formation, whereas here at the first quadrant is second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. In the first quadrant we can write that resultant vector, it is equal AXI plus AYJ, both are positive. In the second quadrant we can write that minus BXI plus BYJ, suffix J. Coming to the third quadrant, both are negative, that is minus CXI minus CYJ. And coming to the fourth quadrant, X factor is positive and Y factor is negative, so then it is DXI minus DYJ. So this is the important for to write the vector quadrants where. So in our previous application we can write in this pattern. So here then 3i plus 4j, what we have, a man moves with the north east 3 meters and north 4 meters, then 3i plus 4j in this direction, we can write that. So this is the important point to note it. And the next, if your block of if your mass of a block on the horizontal surface, so then if the force will be acting on the block, then this force will be divided into two components, that is F cos theta, it is horizontally, it is F sin theta vertically. F sin theta vertically, the weight should be acts always in the downward direction. So this is the concept you have to remember. And the same body is in the moving with the on the inclined plane. So this is the inclined plane. So this is the weight of the body mg, and this can be F cos theta, or nothing but the mg should be divided into mg cos theta, and it can be divided into mg sin theta. So this is the inclined body. This is the horizontal surface. So dear students, please note the all the points. These are very important. So today in our topic, we have learned the addition of the vectors and the subtraction of the vector, and the how we can find the angle between any two vectors. So please note the points and follow me on YouTube, Prasad Physics Tools. So thank you one and all.